All right, this is the finals. This deck has performed admirably. You just beat a deck with two draws of stone. Pretty happy about that. So this is the first mulligan I've had to do all day. I guess that says something about it. So no plane but incremental blight, and any planes I draw turns on enlistment, Kithkin Zealot. Pretty difficult for me to get lands for it unless I draw no lands at all. So I am okay with getting this. Plus incremental blight will allow me to come back from just about anything. It really is just the perfect card. Just completely one-sided, a complete blowout. It's often just, I mean, I guess Wrath of God is better in a lot of circumstances, but I mean, not even in this format. Usually Wrath of God, I think this is better than Wrath of God in this format. It's not better than Hollow Barrel, but I guess that, and that's debatable too, but man. Even Persist guys die. Persist guys cannot live through it. And in a deck trying to go long, I don't even have to do it right away if I don't need to. So I'm waiting for this guy. He's not here yet. He hasn't even seemed to acknowledge that the match existed, so I'll just take a quick... I'll just pause it and go back. Oh, here you go. So, keeping it. Let's draw some planes. Any plane will do. Well, alright, that'll at least it'll stem the tide. Ooh, Flicker Wisp on Elsewhere Flask is a free card. That's really cool. I hope I don't actually use it. Soul Reap, so that's just a complete brick. Interesting. I don't think it's been told to get anybody in this, except, I suppose, with Folio, but I don't think that's gonna happen. I'll have like these two black spells. Yeah, I have a feeling that every single card in his deck is green, so I'm in trouble, I think. Oh, we got his mountain. So you're saying there's a chance. I guess he could have a Grief Tyrant. So definitely not play Flicker Wisp off of Elsewhere Flask because I gotta get that card out of it. I think it's hard to read. Give me one reason. Spring's a hard card to beat. Alright, there it is. Because it's just like, without Wither, it's just very difficult. Of course, with it, all light, it's an easy takeout. And any card with Wither is an easy takeout. I just don't have any Wither. It just sucks. You just get attack with one, no, zero. Because if I attack with both, then Farhaven gets in there. I don't know what that's going to do. That's a free damage. Every point counts because he's the aggressor. I have the deck that's going to be able to have board control eventually. Road is kind of a cool card. It has a lot of, if you are able to pump it up, you can get a lot of mana out of it. A lot of interesting things in this. Take the four and we'll go from there. What do you got for me? It's really cool. You've actually devoted to it with Wolfier Silverheart because you can play Devoted Druid turn 2, Silverheart on turn 3, pumping Devoted Druid, and then you get 4 more mana Devoted Druid to play like some 4 drop, and then you can sack the Devoted Druid and bond with that 4 drop. So it's just outrageous. Oh, Tower Above is a great card of Devoted Druid. You can play it, attack with it, total creature, and then you can make it. Okay. So, there's definitely part of me that wants to take my blight here. I can kill the Devoted Druid, the Hungry Spriggan, and the Juvenile Blue Widow. The reason I like this play is he won't be able to draw basically two less mana. He is behind on lands. So, this definitely seems correct. Then I can just bash in for 5, and there's not much you can do about it. Yeah, that's where I'm going with it. So, it's going to go 1, 2, 3. A complete this is a double stone rail. And Flicker Wisp. Not that, I was saying this before, almost nothing blocks the flyer on this one. And that's definitely Gloom Widow's piece, which I imagine is in the board for one of those flyers. And I suppose you get Gloom Widow itself, the 3-3. And why do you block it? Oh, Fire Spell? He has the Fire Spell, okay. Alright. You have a player. You have it. You have it. Alright, no reason for me to play a land. Might as well just get every ounce of value I can. Some part of me is glad that he played Firestarter early, because now I don't have to send a listen into it. I should have really known that he had Firestarter, given that he's splashing a red mana. Which means it's much less likely that I can plan on having Soul Reap be good. Very unlikely. We have to basically exactly get turn. And then, honestly, I don't even want a Soul Reap. Well, that's really nice. Now that I have Trapper, I'll be able to tap down every turn and get some attack. This is going to be like, you know, 4 damage a turn. Oh boy. Oh. If I would have just left Last Breath up. I really don't think, like, I could have put around that. Like, looking back, obviously, I mean, it seems as though, like, okay, be better safe than sorry. But, like, I definitely wanted to play something else for next turn. And odds are pretty low that he has exactly this card. This card generally isn't played that much. But of course, it's hard to say that looking back. God, goodness. Oh man, my whole life got ripped apart there. And the worst part is he's got 5 cards in his hand. 5. Turn 5, and they're all spells. Money in the land. So I'm pretty worried. Alright. The problem with that card you just played is now, if I overcome the Blizzard, every green creature from now on will have trample. Which has, like, untold consequences. It means my Kithkins can't trade with it, but I am going to have to deal with it. I don't want to, like, quad block because the card just messes with me. So, I'm just going to have to deal with that all the creatures will have trample. Now, hopefully, that won't matter too much. However, I'm just taking hard to scramble. I guess the worst card I could play on is the Crab Apple, you know, the high card. That one you love trample. That's fine. Four cards. One could be a spell. I mean, it could be a land. So I'm looking pretty far behind. At least he has 2 swamps. That's some sort of a good sign. He's Soul Reap has a chance. Okay, I got a target for Soul Reap. I'm just going to straight away. Plus, there's some chance that he's playing Pig Skulking. That's the only reason he's playing Pig Skulking. If I reap here, if he's playing 2 swamps, it's actually all right. I take it back. There's some part of me that thinks maybe he's playing black creatures if he's playing 2 swamps. The Pig Skulking will be there tomorrow. You know, I can just always kill it then. And attacking with Kithkin never goes out of style. Yep, I'm gonna wait. I didn't play the Senseless from there because the Safehold Sentry actually has a huge value in just being able to attack. And not die at anything. Not that it'll lie, I mean. Of course, in the listener, there's a good chance I won't be able to attack at all next turn. If he plays like a big green creature. Odious Trow. Well, thanks, Skulking doesn't work with that very well. Oh, against Wither! I thought against Persist. Okay, Wither. That's interesting. That's even worse than I thought it was going to be. So, I guess on instep, I could Last Breath the Odious Trow. I don't think it's going to get any better than that. He's definitely going to, you know, be able to regenerate for the rest of the game. And it's going to be annoying. But maybe I want to save Last Breath for another creature. If he's playing Odious Trow, maybe he has 2 gifts, and I need to be able to kill it next turn. So I take it back. I'm not going to do it. I'm at a kind of a standstill anyway. I do want to, like, apply pressure, but my whole deck doesn't apply pressure. The entire deck isn't made to, like, win when he's on 5 life, so getting him there may not be the most important things to do, I suppose. Oh man, if I play Renclaw Trow, Man, if I play Ringclaw and then Soul Reap, I can make him lose three life. It's actually not nothing. And then if he plays the other card, I will be sad. But he'll have to attack into Renclaw Trap, so at least there's that. All right. So if I attack with both, then I don't lose it to the gift. I'm just gonna assume he doesn't have gift. If he has gift, then I Renclaw Trap will put it back down to size. So it'll be, not as bad as it looks. I am absolutely putting him on two of this card though. I know Sector West said it's they don't play it at all, but playing Odious Trow is not normally like something that's advisable. It's not the worst, just like not very good. Does he really have it? He's tapping five. It looks like he's going for it. Oh no, he's backing out. I think he has it. I'm like pretty sure about it. Is Reclaimer Bliss just giving me a little bit dividends here and there? Just getting can get some value in my investments. I don't want to attack with the Kithkin just yet. It would be a free block and he'd go to five, sure, but like this isn't the turn for it. Next turn is the turn for it, I think. And just to play around, normally I would not. Oh, wow, what's he doing? What is this? Flame Jab. Okay. Comes back? Yeah, no problem with that. I'm gonna keep the Last Breath up to be able to play around that one spell I was talking about. Even though like Scent Enlistment is a nice one to have next turn. Nothing I can do about that. Can't untap it. At least he's using all his cards. It's nice to know that his hand was just removal spells and not big creatures, because I can beat removal spells. I have inevitability with Scent Enlistment that allows me to be able to grind out that game. Also, it's nice to know that his deck has a lot of really expensive removal, because that's where Scent Enlistment really shines. Of course, I can always just draw awesome creatures. I'm gonna get in a free attack with Renclaw. There's a chance that I should have like attacked with Renclaw first, but I don't think he was blocking either way. Now he's definitely not gonna block, but perhaps he would have blocked otherwise. Or maybe he doesn't know that Wither and Regeneration don't have a good interaction. Who knows? You always forget, I suppose. He's thinking about it. He's really thinking about it. Crazy. That would be a really awesome, okay, awesome. Maybe not the right word for it. It'd be really crazy if he did that. What do you got for me? Do you have that five drop we were talking about? Do you have the gift? It wouldn't even be that good, because Valinok just takes care of it. Five mana, it's not nothing. Torrent of Souls on Desecrator Hag, which gets back anything, I suppose. Yeah, go ahead. Faneskulkin is returned to. Oh wow, okay, so pretty good turn for him. Not the best, but not the worst. Having Faneskulkin give Odious Trow Wither is kind of annoying. But this is kind of cool. I'll be able to attack with Dawn that cohort, and he might just get a little bit dicey and try to. No, he's not. He's just gonna block it with his trap. Okay. I was trying to be the tricky one. Look, I'm a bliss. That's the biggest problem with it, is that it's a May ability, so you have to click yes over and over and over again. Alright. I don't think he's gonna block anyway here, so I'm not gonna like put myself at risk. It gives him like an opportunity to mess up, but I don't wanna do that. I don't wanna give him the option. Playing Sunblast but here is worse if I draw Folio, but it's better for like every other reason. And like if he draws nothing, I might just end step kill the hag and then just start bashing it with everybody. He has no really good blocks. Nettle Sentinel, come on. So now I basically just can't attack for a while. Now I just gotta send the list over and over again. I'll just save the last breath for something that's actually relevant. Because at this point, none of these cards matter. Odious Trow's a problem, but I'm not gonna waste it on that. It's just a regenerator, and all my creatures just don't do anything. I mean, if I had that tapper, I could tap Nettle Sentinel, I wouldn't untap. That'd be interesting. That'd be kind of cool. Every time, yes, I do want to gain it. Yes, absolutely, I want to gain it. Right, one more turn, and then it's Bashtown, USA. All right, what do you got for me? Blue Lance? Ugh, if it's white, I have to discard a card. Okay, so I gotta cast it now. Definitely going at Odious Trow. It's the card that I can't beat the most. It sucks that I have to actually discard it. There was no sense of discarding a land, you know, by holding it. It'd be pretty tough to do that, since lands are just as good as spells. Yeah, that's the cool thing about Retrace. Every single card is good. Oh, wow. Yep. Pull them out, kiddo. A little bit of lag here. The computer's going a little slow. Man, Desecrator Hag combined with Desecrator Hag, kind of cool. But you don't even get the choice, it like forces you to get the one you ask you to. So snare this. I like my spot. I like my odds. Wow. That was a pretty preemptive scoop, although maybe he knows his deck better than I do. Alright, so I saw a lot of removal. We saw Soul Reap, we saw Flame Javelin, we saw Gloom Lance, we saw that Gift of the Denizen or whatever, that one that makes me block, which is basically like a removal spell. So I want to be careful how I board here. Besiege the Queen is really good if he's slow, and especially good if he's trying to play the removal game, because I can like be sure that he doesn't have like a good creature base. If his actual creatures can't withstand, you know, my removal, and then he won't have anything to push forward with his removal. So that's where I'd like to be. If I get Old Gaspark and Shield of the Oversoul, that'd be just dandy, but it's a little bit unlikely. I don't want to. I mean, Soul Reap is basically unplayable. There's only one target, and I targeted it with it. Luckily enough, so part of me wants to just put the Glenelendra back in, because he has so much removal that it would definitely be good against him. It's a little psychotic. It's hard to justify it. Inquisitor's Snare has value against the. Against some of his cards. I didn't really see that many black creatures, though. I saw the the Gravedigger, the Odious Trow, and that's it. So Snare, really not all that great. Pale Wayfinder, on the other hand, might be what the doctor ordered. It's good on, once I untap with it, it's pretty unbeatable. With the Resplendent Mentor, that is. I do have to attack with every turn, so there's that. I'm pretty sure Beseech the Queen is amazing. And make sure I have Blight. Blight is like the number one way I can win the game, I think. Rune Servant Riders might be the ticket, although it's pretty bad with all these swamps I'm trying to play. So if I play that, then I want to cut a swamp for a plains, and then that runs into a whole different host of problems. But I think six swamps is probably enough anyway. And it's seven swamps if you consider the Elsewhere Flask. I think Servant Rider will give you a good opportunity to break through, although he does have removal, as always. Presence of the Gone does not seem like a good investment. I just don't think I can play Glenelendra in good conscience, or in bad conscience, or in any conscience, really. Alright, Pale Wayfinder it is. This might actually... Pale Wayfinder has a better chance to break the game open, and it doesn't die to Burn Trail. So I'll put the Swamp back in, Soul Reap's out, and here we go.